Hi everybody, in this video I'm going to walk you through some of Desmos' new statistical features, and if you teach statistics like I do, this is a very exciting day where they've really done a nice job of including now one variable data displays and also some of the distributions we use in AP statistics. So I'm going to walk you through how to make histograms, dot plots, box plots using Desmos, and also distributions, the normal distribution, the binomial distribution, and the t-distribution. So let's talk about one variable displays first. So in Excel here, I've already created a 80 item list. I just told Excel to make 80 numbers at a random between 10 and 50. I've highlighted them here. And the best way to get this data into Desmos is to just simply take your data, right-click it, copy. And I'm going to come to Desmos now, and I can just control V it and put it here, and I have my 80 element list. Now, to make the graphs and be able to do things with this data list, I need to call it something, so I'm going to call it capital A here. And now I'm all set to make my graphs. I'm going to start off with making a dot plot. Dot plot, and notice when I typed dot plot, the letters are no longer italicized. This is a feature Desmos knows is available to us. And I'll make a dot plot of A. And I don't quite see it yet because I'm on my standard 10 by 10 screen, but something very nifty and crafty they've added here is the magnifying glass. That is the zoom fit feature. If I do that, there's my dot plot. And that looks really great. And we can do things like change the color like we normally do. We can have open circles or X's or just the dots, and we can make them different colors. So we'll keep them as blue. We can adjust the size as well. I think that actually looks much nicer depending on my data size. So we have the dot plot. We can also do a histogram. Let's take a look at histograms. We'll do a histogram of A as well. And let's just hide the dot plot for a moment. Let's take a look at the histogram because it has a lot more going on here. Notice my bar heights, I can go by count or by density. So if I want to go by relative frequency, I can click that and zoom fit. And now I'm looking at, notice this is 10%. I can see what the tallest bars are. I have some choices about whether it aligns to the center or to the left of each number on the x-axis. But the part I also want to look at here is I have data set and bin width. So if you just say A, it's going to do a bin width of 1, but I can do comma 5 and have bin widths of 5. And maybe I would like those left aligned. Perhaps I want to do bin widths of 4 or 10, or I want to explore what the best is to use and explore shape. And I can compare that against my dot plot. Actually, let's zoom it again. I can compare it against my dot plot and see how many are in each of the bins there. So they've really done a nice job of making this simple. Type in dot plot, type in histogram, you're all set to go. And the third one we can now do also is box plot. So box plot, and we'll do a box plot of A. And notice the box plot is here in black, kind of sitting on the bottom because it defaults to hovering around the y equals 1 line. But I can change that here. I can offset it, meaning I can move it up and down. So let's move it up to maybe the y equals 15 line. And I can also make it taller. Let's make it height 3. And now I really like this as a display for kids where we can look at the relationship between the box plot and the dot plot where 25% of our data has to be here, and I can see that here, and a whole 50% of my data is spread out here, and I can kind of take a look and compare and contrast the types of graphs. So we have three things available to us now: dot plots, histograms, box plots. Very exciting stuff. So let's put those away for a little bit. Let's put those in a folder in case I come back to them. And now we're going to look at our distributions. Let's put them in a folder. There we go. Put one in a folder, two in a folder, three in a folder, all of them in a folder. We'll hide that all up. Okay. If you teach AP stats like me, we're always looking at normal distributions and binomial distributions. So let's see how they are handled here in Desmos. So for a normal distribution, I'm going to do normal, D-I-S-T, normal dist. Notice, no longer italicized. And in parentheses, we're going to put the mean and the standard deviation. But if I put nothing, it will default to the 0, 1, the standard normal curve. And if I press my zoom fit, I have a nice curve here I can use. Clicking the box gives me the cumulative probability. Notice it defaults to negative infinity to infinity. But if I want to go from negative infinity up to, say, negative 1, I can have that. So I can do left-tailed. Or if I want to have a right-tailed one, if I want to go, let's say, from 1.5 up to positive infinity, if I get rid of the negative 1 and I click someplace else, notice it will default back to the positive infinity. And I kind of like how it's ghosted there. And I can find the probability here. So it's a very slick little interface that's going on here. I can change the mean and the standard deviation to something other than the standard normal curve. Perhaps I want a mean of 10 and a standard deviation of 3. Click my zoom fit, and I can see what's going on here, and I can find any probability that I would like. Perhaps I want to go between 7 and 11. And I have the probability listed here. Okay. So normal distributions. We can also do binomial. Binomial distributions are defined by the number of trials and the successes. So the number of trials, let's say I have a binomial scenario with 40 trials and a probability of success of 0.3. I can see my distribution here. Let's zoom fit that guy. And I can find a cumulative probability. Perhaps we want to find a probability that we have between 10 and 15 successes. And notice what happens here when you do that. The ones that I'm asking for are in blue here with the closed dots and the bars, as opposed to the ones I don't want in the entire distribution. And it will give me the cumulative density function. If I just want to go from 10 to 10, I can have that as well and really do what's a PDF essentially in our world. So binomial distributions are there as well. And the last one we can do is a t-distribution. So I can type in t-dist. And t-distributions, I need a number of degrees of freedom. Let's say I want to have 5 degrees of freedom. We'll zoom on that guy. And I can also compare that to the normal distribution if I wanted to. If I wanted to talk about the differences between these guys, I can now see the difference between a t-distribution with degrees of freedom 5 in green and the normal distribution, which is in purple. So we have a lot of neat things here to play with. One last thing I do want to show you here. Let's start a new blank graph here. One thing I do like about this is if I do binomial distribution, and instead of, let's do 40, but this time do A. So the success probability is now going to be a slider. Let's zoom fit here. And I can make this go between 0 and 1 with a step of maybe 0.01. I can now make a nice little interactive here to show in class to talk about the relationship between the probability and when does it seem to take on a normal-ish shape or to look at the center shape and spread of these things. Okay, so we have 3 things to play with here. We have histograms, dot plots, box plots, and we also have normal, binomial, and t-distributions. Very exciting day for stats teachers in the Desmos world. So go and play and give me feedback about the things you find. Enjoy.